everyone, Dines Trains here, and today we're going to be riding on West Coast Railways' Dalesman Rail Tour from York to Carlisle via the Settle and Carlisle Line. The route will take us northwest from York to Normanton, Wakefield Kirkgate, Leeds and Skipton before heading up this Settle and Carlisle Line, to which I'll refer to the SC, towards Carlisle, the City of Lakes. And then here comes the train, which is formed of a Class 47 at the front and a Class 37 at the rear, with 11 coaches in between.
No, it's a 47. Northern Bell, no. We're in that one. Ooh, we're on the Pullman coach. E. We're in that one. This one. F. I think this is F. Yes. Yep.
Seating is in a 1-2 configuration with bays of 4 on the left and bays of 2 on the right. Seat designs and patterns may vary as we are travelling in a modified Pullman Mark 1 coach. Cards are at your table to help you locate your seat.
Here we are.
Where's the Wi-Fi?
That's nice.
We depart York right on time, with the Class 37 pulling us and the Class 47 pushing us.
We just record the departure.
It's pushing them. Unless there's another engine at the.
It sounds like a 37.
Oh yeah. That's definitely a
jolter. Okay. Oh, there's a DRS over there. I can get that 37 with a back on set with a plate, I think.
Our first stop is Church Fenton, which is a station that nobody has booked to get on the train, so it passes right through.
Extremely wonderful. I find your sense of humour absolutely thrilling. And now I've got to live with this for the rest of my life.
Stick that in the bin, love it.
Oh wow, no one's coming. camera. You've got to look yourself, you've got to make yourself presentable. God, my hair's a mess. There we go.
Station is Wakefield Kirkgate.
Quick.
Don't want it over the laptop.
Come into Wakefield Kirkgate to drink. Drink it quick.
We converge with the East Coast Main Line on the approach to Wakefield Westgate. After Kirkgate Station, we arrive at Wakefield Westgate Station, the main station of Wakefield.
There's Greek. There's
a pizza. There's a pizzeria. There's an Italian restaurant with ornate interior. No Italian. There's Nando's. Yes.
A333 on our left and A195 on our right. We arrive into Leeds.
3002.
Depart Leeds in the same direction as we arrived and pass A331 as we venture onto the S&C.
47 is now pulling us, 37 is just dragged behind or pushing. No, it's helping us all. It's helping. Look at the seat itself. You have
how large is the cable?
Which is sturdy now. Not good quality as well. That's a chair. It's one of the, basically what you get in first dining and premier dining. We'll have a look at the standard class in a minute. Well, you know what I mean. So, it's quite comfortable. A headrest here and an antepcaster with Virgin Lakes. Another rail tour they do. But you can't take it because it's screwed in. Good job, West Coast Railways. Not that we're going to anyway. You have a curtain, which even if you do remove this from the hook here, the curtain doesn't move. It's rude. Not, well, maybe a little, but not much. Okay, I'll do that in a minute. Got a window. Remind us of those kind of things. This is where you get your own ventilation from. There are racks nearly above seats. We could put luggage and they are netting, but they're very secure. There's also... Okay, this seat moves apparently. The seat moves up apparently. There's also... There's generous space. Your legs. There is no recline. And only one... socket. Down here. Which is the power. The lamp. The lamp does work, and if you want to, get away. But West Coast Railways will be very angry at you. So look in here. This is the switch. Just turn it off and on. Obviously COVID, there's plastic, clear plastic dividers. And a magazine rack of sorts, one of the storage cubbies. That's a reflection of us. That's a 333 with a reflection of us. So you have a sort of luggage rack, magazine rack, but it could also be another storage cubby. I've just put my iPad there. So it's all very through the table. It's also used so that to clear up the cable which goes into the lamp. There's a PA system, lamp, lights, and of course air conditioning. The majority of the air conditioning comes out of the window there, which you can move. You see these like you would on any standard mark on railway carriage in the country. And that's that.
Our final stop is Skipton.
Getting some gentlemen, we're about to take some people off. These are include the two people reservations of Dr. William, but not the child because he is a nice kid. We would also like to invite y'all to the destination.
Is this a day out treat for yourselves?
Yes, it is. A lot of people here to help you.
This is good. Beginning. Settle to calm.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. But.
Break something yourself?
They're old engines. The last time I went there,
I went. But you know, the other one was old stock, wasn't it?
With them?
No, it wasn't old, that was the first one.
Oh, right.
It was 1970s.
Right, okay.
Some of those are 1920s, yeah. I'm right that they don't either. All the Bell stock was 70s.
None of the Bell stock consisted of 1970s stock, it was heavily refurbished.
Yeah.
Bridging Castleford. Past Leeds. We'll be coming into Hellerfield Goods Loop soon.
That's quite a good estimation
panel. I still can't believe you don't know how estimation works.
I wasn't exactly sure how the steel got into the cylinder.
It pushes the pistons, doesn't it?
Now we have arrived at Hellerfield, a nice station, but we are placed onto the goods lines rather than blocking one of the other platforms. Please do check out Trainspotting episode 77, the shunting manoeuvres that took place at the station. Our steam locomotive waits in the other goods siding on the opposite side of the station. The steam locomotive is an LMS Jubilee class locomotive, an express passenger locomotive built by LMS, and is numbered 45699 Galatea, but is currently undergoing an identity crisis, and so is renumbered as scrapped classmate 45627 Sierra Leone and 45627 Alberta, which is still around.
It's over there, is it?
There it is. British Standard 6p. Here it is.
with 24 arches and standing at 104 feet, or 32 metres, above Blee Moor, the Ribblehead Viaduct is certainly a sight to behold. We soon passed Dent Station, which is the highest station in England at 1,150 feet above sea level. We arrive into Carlisle. You get 2 hours here to explore the city, but unless you have booked the Pullman dining class, it is highly recommended that you get something to eat rather than exploring the city. Unless, of course, you've bought your own picnic to eat on the train.
Am I on the tracks? Or? Fine.
Oops.
Mark 1. Unfortunately, don't have a lot of time, so this might see us out. After spending your 2 hours exploring the City of Lakes, you get back on board the train. Here, you also get to look at what Standard Class looks like, which is in a 2-2 configuration, which is perfectly fine if you want a budget, but probably not the best on a long rail tour such as this. The buffet car is available to Standard and First Class passengers. You can see the buffet car in this coach, which is found on the left. The buffet car serves a wide variety of hot and cold drinks, and a small variety of hot food.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Here are seats.
We depart Carlisle promptly, and the train waits for no one, so it is advised to see the train and make time to do some train spotting at the station rather than leaving it too late.
Come on.
I wonder if we can buy a
10% off.
Buy a bottle of wine.
You can't.
Buffet.
Bit expensive.
We got the £37.50 in worth of credit in Northern Farm.
Yeah.
What's your tagline? George is a girl from
you don't say that's a key.
Do you want to go to the engine?
Yeah. Ice cream. There's a stop for water. There's a stop for water at Appleby, and there's ice cream for sale. I'm just standing there.
It's delicious.
Fun fact, Appleby is the only station on the entire line to be built out of brick, not local stone.
Leaving the ice creams of Appleby behind, we traverse the Yorkshire Dales once more.
Thank you. beautiful, isn't it? Are you tired? Yeah.
Wasn't any good footage to record a telefield of the movements, but the track shows now have changed back to Diesel. And we are back at York. Final thoughts, it is a wonderful tour, being pulled behind a steam train and all, but there is a lot of competition from competing rail tour companies, starting from different origin stations, so it is best to search about for the best tour which suits you. Tickets-wise, prices start from £42 for standard class, £82 for first class, the class you're in, £120 for Premier First Class, and £210 for Pullman Dining. Whilst little overpriced, it isn't bad value considering what other companies are offering for similar first class experience.